Now we're ready for the matching equivalent of the max flow min cut theorem, the max matching min vertex cover theorem. Consider a bipartite graph G and a matching M. Then the following are equivalent. M is a maximum matching, M admits no augmenting paths, and there is a vertex cover that has the same size as the size of the matching. The proof will be very similar to the max flow min cut theorem. First, we'll show that if M is a max matching, then it can't admit any augmenting paths. Well, suppose not. Then there is some augmenting path, and if we augment M by this path, we get a larger matching, meaning that M was not a maximum as we had supposed. Next, we argue that if M admits no augmenting paths, then there exists a vertex cover that has the same size as M. This is the most interesting part of the proof. We'll let H be the set of vertices reachable via an alternating path from unmatched vertices in L. We can visualize this definition by starting with some unmatched vertices in L, then following its outgoing edges to some elements in R, and then following all the matched edges back to matched elements of L, and back and forth and so forth as many times as we can. Note that because the matching doesn't admit any augmenting paths, all of these paths must terminate in some matched vertex on the L side. Let's draw the rest of the graph here as well. We have some matched vertices in L, the vertices of R that they're matched to, and possibly some unmatched vertices in R as well. Note that H and the complement of H correspond to the minimum cut that we used when discussing the max flow min cut theorem. To get a min vertex cover, we select the part of H that is in R and the part of L that is not, and we call this set S. S contains exactly one vertex of each edge in M. If the edge in M happens to belong to H, then we got its right side, and if it doesn't belong to H, then we got its left side. So the size of S and the size of M must be the same. Next, we need to convince ourselves that S is really a vertex cover. Remember that there are no edges internal to R or internal to L, so we don't need to worry about those. The part of S that is in R covers all the edges internal to our H set of vertices, and these over here in L, they cover all edges in the not H part of the graph. So what we really need to worry about are just edges that go across the cut. Well, from here to here, both vertices in the edge are covered, so we only really need to worry about the part of L that is in H being one vertex, and the part of R that is not in H being the other. But if there were such an edge crossing here, it would have been in H, because we'd be going from a vertex in H via an unmatched edge to R. We conclude that there are no such edges, and hence S is a vertex cover. Finally, we have to prove that the existence of a vertex cover that is the same size as a matching implies that the matching is a maximum. And this follows immediately from our discussion that a vertex cover is an upper bound on the size of a matching. So if it wasn't a maximum matching, then the whole idea of vertex cover wouldn't be an upper bound, as we've argued already.